And in this tutorial, I'll talk about the basics of content fragment and its architecture. Content fragment allow you to design, create and publish page independent content. So what is a page independent content? Suppose you have a page and you need some content on that. So you will be creating that content on a page. And if you need the same content on different pages, so on each page you have to create that content. So in that case, you will be creating that content on each page. But in case of content fragment, you will be creating one content fragment with that content and you will be reusing that content on pages using this content fragment. So now you are creating content only once and you are just reusing it. It allows you to create the variation of that component, means you can have different variations of same content. Content fragment contains purely text and related images content. It is a pure content. It does not have any styling element, like you cannot have any style or layout. Using content fragment, you can create channel specific content, like you can have different content for your mobile apps and different create for your social networkings, and you can have the specific variations for specific channel. You have to use content fragment component to use that content of content fragment on pages. So there is by default a component available in core components, but you can create your own component as well to use this content fragment content. Content fragment also export content in JSON format. It uses the Sling model export capability, like we have already seen how the content is exported using Sling model. Let's understand the architecture of content fragment. First, you have to create a content fragment model. This model defines the structure of your content fragment. In content fragment model, you define the fields of content fragment and its type. You will create content fragment using this content fragment model. So whatever the field you define in content fragment model, now those fields will be available to add your content. You can create different variations of this content fragment data. Each variation can have the different content you added. Like variation 1 can have different content, variation 2, 3 and 4 can have different data for this content fragment model. And you can use any variation on pages. So to use this content fragment model, you have to use a content fragment component. A component is by default available with the core components. You can create your own component as well. So you will use this content fragment model over pages and you configure this content fragment using this component. You can use any variation as well, either master or any variation. You can export content fragment content in raw JSON format as well to any of the third party. You can export this content to any mobile app or any social networking app or any third party application which is consuming that content in JSON format. This is the basic understanding of this architecture. We will see the in detail each section of this architecture in detail in coming tutorials. There's a lot more to understand of content fragment. We'll see that in coming tutorials. But if you have any question, please do comment. Thank you very much.